You know, I have found that spending all the time in the islands that I've spent, you know, down there, things move to their own time. And a single moment, you know, can last for hours, it seems. And days just kind of stand still and hang in the balance. And that was a welcome feeling for me, because when I'm on the road and when I'm out touring, you know, my whole life revolves around a schedule, around a time. There's so many expectations, so many things in my mind. And the warm air always seems to melt those expectations away.
Chesney. Now, Kenny, something I really want to talk about are your live shows. You, oh gosh, you put so much of yourself into your shows and just give so much. And I know that's how you connect so much with your fans. I feel like you're doing that with this album, too. What is it about your fans that gives you so much confidence to just be yourself?
I think that ultimately, that's what they want, is for me to be myself. Mm-hmm. I'm very proud of our fan base, and me and the guys work very hard on stage, and I do feel like, though, that really people are, no matter what you're doing, I feel like they're suckers for the truth. And I know I am when I'm listening to music. I want to feel what they're feeling. I want to know where they've been. I want to see who they've met. I want to, you know, see what's in here. And that's definitely what this record is. So I just feel like that, you know, they're wonderful. My fan base is so wonderful that they'll allow me to do something like this, especially. Like I said earlier, I didn't really want to put this record out, but I wanted my fans to hear it and to see that side of me.
And as much as you travel, in your heart, where do you think home is?
Well, I live here. I've lived in Nashville for a while. Some people would say that my home is in my bus, and that's true. But it's true. I spend a lot of time in the islands, and one thing I love about it is, like, I'll go down there and I'll be walking through a street, and I'll see some random person, and they'll say, "Welcome home, Kenny."
Wow.
And that means a lot to me, yeah. And it has become my home.
You still go back to Luchel Lake for Christmas and stuff,
oh, sure.
Don't you?
I cannot do it without my grandmother. I've been to my grandmother's house at Christmas every year. Yeah, I can't not do that.
Has she got something that she's special that she makes for you that you love to have every Christmas?
Oh, anything she makes is good.
Aw, you're a good boy. They raised you good. You know, when you're in the islands...
It's not that good. I mean, it's not good for this, but it's good.
She don't care about that.
No.
Now, when you are down in the islands, do you think maybe you're kind of a different person than people here think you are?
Well, like, you know, people are used to seeing me in a certain way.
Yeah.
They're used to seeing me, you know, on TV and videos, and they're used to seeing me on stage with a lot of lights and with a lot of video screens and some music that's pretty rocking and pretty loud. And that is so not who I am when I'm down there and when I'm off the road. I'm very quiet. I'm very simple. I'm a very simple person, really. And I think they'd be surprised at how different I really was, you know, because when I hear my drummer, Sean, we're on stage and I hear that kick drum hit me in the back, I can't help but move and I can't help but be energetic. And
we like the way you move too, right? That wiggle.
But when on my boat, I don't want to move. I just want to lay there, you know, hang out.
We're not going to see you alone on your boat doing that wiggle out in the middle of the ocean, nobody around.
Well, you might, but...
You know, for someone who is so much in the public eye, you do an incredible job of keeping your private life private. How do you do it?
That seems to be the topic of conversation. You know what? I am an intensely private person. I really am. And I need to be, you know, as a songwriter, I need to have something to draw from, you know, was engaged once, and to be honest with you, we've been broken up longer than we dated, but it's true, you know, but still, you know, people, we're still breaking up to her, you know, this person didn't want to be in the limelight. I chose it. And bless her heart, she's still dealing with it. That's so right. For that reason, I mean, I just, you know, I just choose to keep what I do very, very, very private.
Yeah. Well, I don't blame you. I don't at all. Now, speaking of fame, this next song, this is one of my favorites. Sherrie's Living in Paradise. Mm-hmm. Despite your millions of fans around the world, you actually found one lady who didn't know who you were. I don't know how that's possible. And actually inspired you to write this song. Tell us the story there.
Well, this song is where this album was born. I didn't really know it at the time. And this was the first song that I wrote about my life down there. And several years ago, Clayton, I wrote this song with my guitar player, Clayton, and he and I and another musician of mine, Nick, we were down in the islands and at this little restaurant and had this girl, this really attractive girl waiting on us. And obviously, we, you know, didn't leave her alone. You know, we aggravated that girl to death.
Lucky girl.
And so she said, "What do you guys do?" And I said, "Well, I'm a singer and a songwriter, and these guys are in my band." And she goes, you know, she acted like she really didn't believe us. And I said, "I tell you what," I said, "if we leave you alone," I said, we will leave you alone. But before I leave the island, I'm going to write a song about you. And I'm going to play it for you to prove it to you.
And you did, right?
And so I wrote this song. Clayton and I, over the next, you know, 4 or 5 days, sat down and wrote this song. And I didn't have a way to put it down. I didn't even... You know, there was no recording studio there, and I didn't even have a boom box to record it onto a cassette. So when we finished the song, I grabbed my guitar, got in a Jeep, and drove across the island to the restaurant where she was working, pulled her out of the restaurant and sat her down on this little bench and played her the song.
And we will be forever jealous. Sherrie, I hope you're watching.
So yeah, well, I think she lives in San Diego now. So Sherrie, if you're watching, this song's for you.
All right, here's Sherrie's Living in Paradise. Take it away.
Sherrie's living in paradise, slinging drinks at a bar down by the beach. And you know she came here from L.A., Southern California could not hold her dreams. And she's happy now, it seems, 'cause Sherrie's living in paradise, chasing something or running from something. Had a lot of lovers that were good for nothing. And she thought about leaving once or twice, but she's still in the sun and this laid-back life. Sherrie's living in paradise. Somehow the salty air, it soothes her soul. Says it makes her home. She gets hit on by the tourist, but she rushes it off 'cause she's heard every line. She just takes it in stride, 'cause Sherrie's living in paradise, chasing something or running from something. Had a lot of lovers that were good for nothing, and she thought about leaving once or twice. She's still in the sun and this laid-back life. Sherrie's living in paradise. Laid back life, Sherrie's living in paradise.